Welcome back to the M-STEP Computer Adaptive Assessment for ELA and Mathematics video training series. Chapter 3, the M-STEP Mathematics Computer Adaptive Test. In this chapter, we will discuss the item types, tools, and functionality that are specific to the M-STEP Mathematics Assessment. In the CAT, students need to answer an item to move to the next item. A partially completed response box will allow students to move to the next item. For example, if the item requires students to move three numbers to correct positions on a number line, moving just one number to the number line will allow them to advance to the next item. Note how the next button is dark gray. This signals that the next button is active and that a student may select next to advance to the next item. If a student does not answer the item, or responds and then uses the eraser tool to erase the response, the next button will be light gray, signaling that it is not active, and the student will be unable to advance to the next item until a response is given. In this item type, note that students may answer both rational and irrational for the same number. However, students cannot select more than one option on multiple choice items. Partially completed drag and drop items also allow students to continue to the next item. In most mathematics CAT items, except for the items we will describe next, the input of just one response, even if the item requires multiple responses to be correct, will allow students to continue to the next item. These items require a full response in all cells before the test taker is allowed to continue. This is a two-part item. In this item, students must enter a response in both cells to continue to the next item. In this sample, the missing response in the second cell results in a light gray next button, preventing students from advancing to the next item. Once a response is made, the next button will change to dark gray and students may continue to the next item. In this grade 5 item, students must input a response in all cells in order to move to the next item. Similarly, in this grade 7 item, students must enter a response in both drop-down menus to continue on to the next item. The Mathematics CAT has several tools embedded in the test items. The keypad input allows students to enter numbers by clicking on the online keypad or from their physical keyboards. Alpha characters that appear on the keypad input may also be entered from keyboards. The keys available will vary depending on the item. Any necessary variables will be included. The keypad input allows for the entry of numbers, fractions, expressions, and equations. This is the fraction tool in the keypad input. When the student selects the fraction tool in the keypad input, the fraction tool will appear in the input space and the cursor will blink in the numerator box. This indicates that the student may make an entry in the box from their keyboard or from the keypad input. There are two ways to make the denominator box active. The first way is to use the tab key on the physical keyboard. The blinking cursor will appear in the denominator box. The second way is to click in the shaded denominator box. This will also make the denominator box active and the student may make an entry. If the student makes a mistake, the eraser tool can be used to erase the fraction. The keypad input does not perform any actual calculations. Calculations are to be performed with a calculator. Students in grades 6 and 7 will use the calculator embedded within the online delivery engine. The calculator will appear in the toolbar when items allow its use. It will not appear when items do not allow its use. There are two types of embedded online calculators. In grade 6, students will see the basic calculator for items that allow its use. Ending grade 7, students will be provided with a scientific calculator for items that allow its use. Some items in grade 6 and 7 will have the keypad input and a calculator. Other items will have either the keypad input or the calculator, and some items will have neither tool. Students in grades 3, 4, and 5 will not be provided with a calculator at any time for any item, as the use of calculators at these grade levels changes the construct of the items and what they are intended to measure. Another tool students may encounter in the Mathematics CAT is a protractor. This digital tool is used to measure angles. For items that require a protractor, students will see this icon. Students may also encounter two types of graphing tools, a number line in grades 3 through 7, or a coordinate grid in grades 5 through 7. All of the buttons needed to answer the question will be provided with the graphing tools. Even after viewing this video, you may still need more information. To experience the many different tools and item types, students and teachers can enjoy the added benefit of practicing the tools and navigation of the MSTEP CAT test by going to the MSTEP Training Tutorials and the Online Tools Training, or OTTs, portal. The DRC Online Tools Training portal can be accessed through the Chrome browser only at this URL. The OEAA recommends that classroom teachers introduce online testing to their students by playing the student tutorial videos in class to show students how the online testing system and tools work. Once the student tutorial videos are shown and discussed in the classroom, teachers can then show the online tools training to the entire class. After students have watched the student tutorial videos and watched the teacher navigate through the OTTs using a projector or any other projecting device, each student should be provided hands-on practice with the online sample item sets contained within the OTTs, ideally using the device they will use during testing. Each item type that a student might encounter on the MSTEP Mathematics CAT is represented in the sample item sets. For additional practice, students can access the calculator practice or the graphing practice items, also available through the training tutorials and the online tools training portal. If you have additional questions concerning the MSTEP Mathematics assessment, send an email to mde-oeaa@michigan.gov with MathCAT in the subject line. MDE staff will be sure to address your question in a timely manner. For more information about the MSTEP assessments, see the MSTEP Test Administration Manual. For more information about the other state summative assessments, see the Guide to Michigan State Assessments document. Both documents are available at www.michigan.gov/OEAA. Thank you for joining us for this series of training videos on the MSTEP Computer Adaptive Test for English Language Arts and Mathematics. We hope you have found them informative and helpful.